Manager's report, Ms. Dukes.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Good evening, Commissioners. As we are recovering from Hurricane Helene, the normal order of business also moves forward. So we are so grateful for our teams. Our staff has done an incredible job over the last 2.5 weeks taking care of this community and getting everyone back on their feet. We've talked about some of those things in particular yesterday at the work session. But as a part of that, with an already very busy fire department, they kicked off Fire Prevention Month for October this week. So I have the schedule. If any of you would like a copy of this, I can give this to you if you would like to appear at any of these events. The majority of them are to visit school children. That's a big part of Fire Prevention Week, but not all of it. We have some public education opportunities as well. Also, we will be hosting Leadership Lounge on Thursday. They are in line for their Courts and Public Safety Day with the adult class, but given the response that we're all still under as a part of Helene, we have an abbreviated program that we'll be hosting here in this room. So if any of you are interested in attending, let me know. We'll be providing the class with an overview of the storm and our response. Also, I forwarded you all earlier today the Ag Tour schedule for tomorrow that's hosted by the Extension Office. If you remember, after Hurricane Idalia, we had FSA come in with our Extension Office's tour several of our local farms to really get some input. As you know, there's over $6 billion in ag loss to Georgia's economy, which also affects our food at the end of the day. So our farmers, I remain in our thoughts and prayers as we move forward in recovering from Helene. Representative John LaHood has an event at Coleman Tally Thursday evening at 5 p.m. that you all are invited to. We have two items for consideration next week that we will need to have a meeting Tuesday evening for. At the direction of the chairman, we have canceled the work session since we are having our work session and our regular meeting tonight as a delay of the hurricane, but we have two items that can't wait until your November meeting. So we'll have an abbreviated meeting schedule next week with that. Also, we are working closely with the Department of Family and Children's Services. Some of you have gotten some comments over food insecurities for some of our citizens as a result of Helene. The Red Cross continues to provide some hot meals, but that will start to dwindle down. What DFACS will do is bring in what is referred to as the DSNAP program. It's basically disaster benefits for families with food insecurity. So this is not technically always for people who are already receiving food stamp type benefits. These are for people who may not qualify for those benefits, but that again still have lost, maybe they lost everything that they had in their refrigerator or their freezer, and they've just got some food insecurities there. So the state will be bringing a team of about 300 people that will be serving in a county area, not just Lowndes County around us. So we're in the process of working with DFACS to get all of that scheduled. So yeah, citizens who are calling in that have those issues, if you'll let us know, then we'll get them connected with the times and the location for them to be able to apply for those benefits. And that concludes my report, Mr. Chairman. Thank you all for your support. I will tell you that some of the policies and the procedures and the funding that you all put into place after Idalia, that from a pre-disaster mitigation standpoint, such as the crisis track software, we have definitely seen the benefits of those things from our response to Helene. So thank you for your continued leadership and support. We will come to you again with the lessons learned when we finish this recovery through the next budget cycle to see what other things need to be put in place community-wide for us to be better, even better prepared next time.
Well, I think that's all great, but I think we've had enough opportunities to learn, so.
All right. I agree, Mr. Chairman. Thank you.
I do want to say, Commissioners, Ms. Dukes, your staff, and the citizens. This has been a very tough situation that we've had to go through in the last 13 months. It's unprecedented that we've been hit with three basically hurricanes, and that we had two of them hurricane strength here in Lowndes County. Just totally and completely unheard of. But how this community has stood up, how they have cooperated, how they have come together and worked as a community to get through this is just unprecedented. You can listen to stories that the same storms affected other areas, that it was not as smooth as it has been, as difficult as it has been here in Lowndes County. We have folks now that still does not have electricity to their homes. Now, that's not because of the fact that we don't have the hard work help from the utilities that's providing it. It's because there's just repairs that has to be made before they can get their electricity back to their homes. But our electrical utilities, the great work that they did, both from the Georgia Power, both from EMC, to get everybody up and going, again, just unprecedented. And the lessons that was learned from Idalia, certainly those lessons, we took those to fruition. This community bowed their back, we stood strong, we stood tall, and we did what we had to do as a community to be able to get through this. I'm extremely proud of the commission, certainly the staff, but more than anything, I'm proud of this community.
Mr. Chairman, if I could, there's someone at the helm of all of that that makes good recommendations every single day. Ashley, could you stand up, please? I know that you reported yesterday, but I'd just like an opportunity to recognize you publicly. So if any of you who are in attendance tonight wonder who is leading the charge as far as our local policies, securing resources, working with our elected officials, coordinating all the things that it takes to restore the community, it is this man right here, and I could not be more prouder of his efforts. So thank you again, Ashley, for everything.
Hell of a weatherman.